Hey guys, so today's video is going to be a very, very exciting one. I'm so excited to sit down and film this. It's gonna be a review slash first impressions demo application on the new Fenty products. I'm so excited. Fenty Beauty came out with this Body Lava Body Luminizer and this Glittering Pom Pom. I have been so excited for these products. The second they were available on Sephora, I immediately ran and purchased it so that I could do this video for you guys. And I know there are tons of people who already have this video up who have already reviewed this, but I thought maybe you want to hear what I think as well. Maybe we like the same things. Maybe we have the same skin tone. I don't know. But I'm here to give you my thoughts, my first impressions, and we're gonna apply it to the body, this area here, and we're gonna see how it looks. Not gonna lie, I've been reading some mixed reviews, especially on Sephora. I'm a little bit nervous. I really, really, really wanna like this because, I mean, I think this is the best packaging I've seen in a really long time. Her packaging is incredible, and I'm a huge packaging person. Like, I love packaging, and I mean, even just the boxes. Like, look at these boxes. The only thing I didn't purchase was the Face and Body Kabuki brush. I was like, I have kabuki brushes at home. Do I really need it? But then after a couple days later, I regretted it and then I purchased it. But it doesn't get here till tomorrow and I'm planning on posting this video tomorrow, so that doesn't help me. We're just gonna use a different brush. I figured there's gonna be tons of people out there who might purchase this product but not purchase the matching brush because a lot of us have brushes at home and or maybe a lot of us wanna use our fingers, I don't know. But for the sake of this video, I will be using my Tarte Kabuki brush. This is just like a giant Tarte Kabuki brush. The Fenty one is a little bit stiffer and like it looks like it's a lot more dense, but we're gonna use this and if all else fails, we'll use our fingers. Okay, so I haven't even opened this box. I am so excited. Wait a second. Let me do it through the bottom. Okay. Wow. This, wow. Just wow. This is a lot bigger than I thought it was gonna be. This is like, holy, look at this. That's big. I wanna display this. This is so beautiful, I want to display this. Packaging gets a huge A+ for me. Now, I don't know if the packaging is the reason this is so expensive because this bad boy is $59. 60 bucks for a body luminizer. That's a bit steep. We'll see if it's worth it, but the packaging is definitely worth it. Like, if you're gonna price this at 60 bucks, it better come in a packaging like this. You know what I mean? So, wow, this is beautiful. And I got the shade Who Needs Clothes. She does have two shades. I figured this one was better for my skin tone. The other one just seems too deep for me. I will say this does look very, very glittery, and I don't like glitter, but I don't mind it on the body. I hate glitter on the face, like on the cheeks, but on the body, I like it. In the spring and summer, like, I'll rock it. Let's just see how this formula goes. And then the other product is the Fairy Bomb. And this says it's a plus shimmer packed puff and it gives you an instant body glitz. This is in the shade Rosé on Ice. By the way, these products are limited edition, but yeah. Why is this so difficult? This is so luxe. I feel like this is kind of like Charlotte Tilbury packaging. We haven't really seen a company, well, recently, we haven't really seen a company come out with things like this. I remember back in the day, my mom used to have something very similar to this. I'm gonna try this one out after, okay. So I'm just gonna shake this up. I don't know if you have to, but I'm just gonna shake it up. This does come in a pump. I don't know if I should just like drop it, you know, like Rihanna did it, like everybody's doing it. Okay. I feel like this brush might actually soak up a lot of the product. This smells so freaking good. I'm actually gonna, wait. It says it's a limited edition gel-based body luminizer made to veil skin in a glorious dewy high shine finish. This says it has a floral vanilla scent. I don't smell the floral, but, well, I guess. Oh my God, but it just smells so good. It smells like vanilla. Okay, I'm gonna try one more time here with the brush. But I might apply it with my hands. Oh my gosh, look at this. It does feel sticky though, like it feels oily. And I don't like that feeling, but we're gonna push through it, let's see. I feel like less is definitely more with this product, but I just wanna see how it applies with the fingers. Ooh, that just made it more intense. It just makes your hands all glittery, but you could just wash that off. You don't need a $34 brush. Okay, so this is definitely more of like a dewy finish, like a sweaty dewy finish. It's not so much a sheen or a shimmer, because there are other body luminizers I've tried in the past. They're a little bit more cream based and they're kind of like liquid highlighters. This is not like a liquid highlighter. This is a dry oil kind of, maybe not as dry as a dry oil. It's a little bit oily with a bunch of shimmer in it. So this is more to give your skin that sweaty, wet look, not so much that highlighted sheen. And I would imagine that this texture would probably be awkward if you're like hugging someone. And it probably will get on your clothes, the glitter. But this is this shoulder. Let me add some more back here. I feel like it's a little naked back here. So this is this shoulder, and this is the bare shoulder. I'm actually gonna apply the glitter pom-pom on this side. It smells so freaking good though. Okay, so the Fairy Balm retails for $42, which is also pretty pricey for what it is, but let's see. Okay, so I'm just gonna like, I don't know. They say that you need to dab this onto the body. Oh yeah, I totally see it. You have to like dab a little harder. But I definitely see it. Oh, wow. Wow, I put a lot right there. Holy caca. If you want a little bit of a shimmer, this is super cute. But it is pretty expensive. I feel like you're kind of paying for the experience. Like, ooh, I bet you it would make this side look really intense because it would have that oil to stick to. This would probably be really nice to like set the oil down. No, never mind. But it does make it shimmerier. I'm gonna zoom you in now just so you can kind of see the shimmer. I'm not even sure you can see the shimmer on there. But it's shimmery. Okay, I'm gonna add some more of the body lava on this side. Okay, so I do like the dewiness. I like the glow. I like that this is making me look a little sweaty. I like it. But I'm actually gonna wait about 5 minutes and I'm gonna see if this maybe dries down. It probably doesn't, I know it's an oil, but maybe it gets a little less tacky. I don't know. But I will be right back to give you my final thoughts. We're gonna wrap up this video and I'm gonna tell you how I feel. So I have mixed emotions about these products. First, let me talk about the body lava. A few things I love about this. I love that it has a pump. I love the packaging. It's absolutely stunning. Killer. Best packaging they could have done. I love the scent. I keep smelling myself like, that looked like I was trying to smell my armpit, but I smell so vanilla-y. I love the color. It's so universal. Because there really isn't a base color to it, it's not really a liquid highlighter. It's just a bunch of rose gold, silver, and pink shimmer kind of like thrown in this mixture, this like oily mixture. Because of that, this can suit so many different skin tones. Anybody can really wear this color, even the fairest of fair to the deepest of deep, I think. I also like the glow it gives my skin. Like when I'm sitting here, I'm looking in the mirror, I love this glow. It does look sparkly, but it just looks so summery and fun. But a couple things I don't like. I don't like that this is kind of oily. It is getting tacky. So the oil gets even tackier as it's sitting on your skin, which wouldn't be a problem for me if I'm not planning on like hugging anyone, holding someone's baby or something. It's sticky and it is tacky. So if you don't like anything sticky, you will absolutely hate this. But that being said, I feel like this would be perfect for summertime. The only thing that concerns me about that is, okay, so I'm gonna apply my SPF underneath this, right? Lather up my body with SPF and then I would put this on top. Hey guys, I'm so sorry, but the next few minutes are a little bit blurry. For some reason, my camera decided to focus on the board behind me, and I don't know why, but it's been doing this recently. Does anybody know if maybe I did something wrong? Did I click something on my camera? But for some reason, recently it has just been focusing on the board behind me or on objects behind me, and it never used to do that before. And I just didn't notice because I still use my viewfinder. I don't use a big monitor or anything, so I didn't notice I was out of focus. So I'm so, so sorry, but the next few minutes are a little bit out of focus, or a lot of bit out of focus, but then it does go back to normal towards the end. So I'm so, 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 so sorry. Don't be mad. And because it's so tacky, I kind of feel like if you were to jump into a pool or like if you were to get into the ocean, I kind of feel like it would stay. So maybe that would work, but I feel like it would be kind of awkward to reapply sunscreen on top of this. I don't know. I think it would also work for a night out, like if you're gonna go clubbing. I feel like it would look so nice underneath the lights at nighttime or like in flash photography. Like I think aesthetically it is really nice. But I don't know if I would use this that often. Even though I like it, I did like this product, I'm not loving it, I'm not completely blown away. For me, it's just, it's too sticky, and it is a $60 product. So I'm gonna say I don't think this is worth your money. I would say go to Sephora, get a sample, because it is a very specific texture. For me, it's okay, I like the look it gives me, but it's not something I'm like, yes, I need this, you know? And the same goes for this. For me, I find that this is more worth it than this. Even though this is pricier, for $42, honestly, you can get any loose glitter you have in your collection or like a loose shimmer powder and just like throw it on the body for less money, I feel. I hate to say it, but I just don't think it's like, wow, you need it, run to Sephora, get it right now. It's just okay in my opinion. I just feel like it is a lot of money, but I'm still gonna use it and I'm still gonna make it work. I wonder how this would transfer, like if I hug somebody with a white shirt on. You know what, I'm gonna go grab a white shirt. Margaret, hello, darling. Haven't seen you in so long. I actually don't see anything except little tiny little specks of glitter. I mean, the shimmer transfers just a little bit, but because this isn't really a color and it's more like tacky oily, it doesn't really get on Margaret. Margaret's fine. You can totally hug Margaret if you're wearing this. It's okay. But anyway, guys, that completes this video. Those were my initial thoughts, my first impressions. Let me know in the comments below how you feel about these products. Have you tried them out? What are your thoughts? I would love to know what you guys are feeling about these two products. Let me know in the comments below. Also, if you tried out the Kabuki brush, let me know how that goes. Is it good? I get it tomorrow. I guess we'll see. But that completes this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you in my next video. Bye. So, oh my, when the heck did I get these? Damn mosquito. Oh, what the heck? Let me take this little thing out. Zoom you in now just so you can see.